Assalamualaikum to all my dear students. Welcome to the online class. Today we will learn new poem in unit 3. Poem is On the Water. Do you have any idea about this topic related, that is on the water? Yes, it is something kind related to the water. Let us recite the poem first. In our little boat to glide on the water blue and white, while the sky is smooth and bright, what could give us more delight? See the ripples, how they run, twinkling brightly in the sun, while reflected we can see shadows of each hill and tree. See the lilies round and large, floating near the reedy marge, where the bulrush has its place and the heavy water maze. See the great green dragonfly and the swallow skimming by. See the fishes spring and gleam ere they splash into the stream. See the bright kingfisher too dart a gleam of green and blue. These are all around our boat on the water whilst we float. So students, let's start with the first stanza. In our little boat to glide on the water blue and white, while the sky is smooth and bright, what could give us more delight? Here, glide means to move smoothly. Delight, that means happiness. So, in the first stanza, the poet begins by telling us that he is in a boat, and the boat is moving smoothly away on the river that is wide and its water is blue and the sky is clear and bright. Or in other words, the poet wants to tell us that it is a beautiful day. And he further puts his thought that, or his question, that what else could give us more happiness than this beautiful day and the clear blue waters of the river? Next stanza. See the ripples, how they run, twinkling brightly in the sun, while reflected we can see shadows of each hill and tree. Ripples. Student, ripples means a number of waves formed on the surface of the water due to the breeze or when an object is dropped in it. Have you ever throw a stone in a water? That time what do you have see? Some kind of small waves. That's our ripples. So in the second stanza, poet is pointing to the ripples and telling us to watch how they are shining brightly in the sun rays as they move on the surface of the water. The clear water of the river is reflecting the image of all the hills and trees. Third stanza. See the lilies, round and large, floating near the reedy marge, where the bulrush has its place and the heavy water maze. Reedy, here the reedy means a tall grass growing near the corner or near the edge of the water bodies. Marge, that means edge or corner. Bulrush, it's a wetland or grass like wetland grass like plant. Water maze, again that means some plants growing near the edge of the water bodies. So reedy marge, bulrush and water maze, that means waters edge where reeds or tall grasses grow thick, or grass like plant growing near the edge of the water bodies. In the third stanza, poet is telling us to see the large round lilies are floating near the edge of the river that is full of reeds, full of tall grasses. And the poet tells us that we can also find the other water plants like the bulrush and water mace. Fourth stanza. See the great green dragonfly and swallow skimming by. See the fishes spring and gleam ere they splash into the stream. Swallow means that is a name of a bird. Skimming means searching. Okay. Spring, that means leap or jump. Gleam, that means shine. And air, that means before. So, in the fourth stanza, the poet is now pointing at the dragonfly and the swallow, the bird, that are skimming the water of the river. The poet is also advising us to quickly watch the fishes that are shining as they jump about before they dive back into the water and disappear. See the bright kingfisher too, dart a gleam of green and blue. These are all around our boat on the water whilst we float. So here dart means move suddenly and quickly, as whilst, that means while. So in the last stanza, the poet is telling us to see the kingfisher bird as it darts or as it's moving quickly about in search of fishes. The poet ends the poem by saying that these insects, birds, fishes, plants, trees and hills are all around him as they move in their boat. So students, what's the message in this poem the poet wants to give us? Yes, the poet or this poem gives us message to observe every part of the nature which is around us. I hope you all understood this poem. If you have any ask, you can ask me. Till then, take care. Thank you. Jazakallah.